Now with Node.js installed in the VM, you can begin coding and running your Node.js programs. Node.js is a JavaScript runtime that executes scripts directly. It uses an event-driven, non-blocking input and output model to optimize concurrent access to resources. Because of this, Node.js is very good at creating web servers. Its event model allows Node to work only when needed. If a new client connects to your server, the connection event is fired, and then Node goes back to being idle. This model is not exclusive to server-side technologies. The event-based model is applied everywhere in Node.js. Almost all the libraries in Node uses this event-driven model. For example, to read a file, instead of opening, reading, and closing it in a sequence, you may open the file and add an event listener for each line read. This way, your code focuses on what you do with each new line. The function you provide is called as new lines are read from the file. This might be overwhelming if you're coming from a procedural language, but as you code in JavaScript with Node.js, this becomes common practice. Following this design principle, Node.js achieves a non-blocking input-output model. This is: when you write your code and you must handle an asynchronous task like handling network connections, the event is registered and your code continues executing. This makes applications written in Node very scalable, since your application executes only when it needs to. To start using Node.js, you can use the Node Read Evolve Print loop, which is the Node.js shell. It is called REPL for short. Simply run the Node command in a new terminal window. You can now run any JavaScript instruction and the shell will output the result evaluating your code. For example, you can create a variable with var foo equals hello world. Undefined is printed on the screen, as the entire expression resolves to nothing. Now, if you type the name of the variable, foo, hello world is printed on the screen. This is because everything that you do in the REPL will be evaluated and printed. In Node.js, to print to the console you use console.log. Running console.log foo prints in the console hello world, and since the function itself returns nothing, the REPL prints undefined. You can use the REPL to practice some basic JavaScript, but writing complex scripts in REPL is complicated. Instead, you write JavaScript files and execute them using Node. To exit the REPL, you can call process.exit, and this terminates the Node process that's running, or alternatively, press Ctrl-C. To run a JavaScript file, you must create it. Open a text editor. Add the same sentences that we used in the REPL. Create a variable and then log it using console.log. Save the file. I name it index.js. In my case, I save it inside the home folder, projects, simple.js. Now open a terminal window and go to the folder where you saved the JavaScript. In my case, /home/oracle/projects/simple.js. Now run node index.js. Note that the file outputs a simple hello world and stops. Node.js programs stops when there are no more events registered to run. Since the code I wrote doesn't register any event, then the program stops upon reaching the final statement. Node.js includes a package manager to add dependencies to your projects, called NPM, or Node Package Manager. To start using NPM, you must initialize your project. This is done by running npm init in the folder where you have your Node.js project. Answer the prompts. In my case, I use the default suggested by the tool. Defaults are displayed between parentheses. When done, it creates a package.json file, which is your project configuration. Whenever you add a library to your project, this file is updated. It contains information about your project as well. Now that you know how to run Node.js scripts, try running the simple script I just shown. If you are new to JavaScript, this is a good time to look for some basic exercises. And if you know JavaScript, you can use the REPL to practice. Next, I show you how to create a web server with Node.